Hello students, welcome to another session of our practicals. In this session we will be going through and showing a demonstration on appetizers. So in this session we'll be seeing through five classical appetizers, and we are going to start with something called as crudites.
So what are crudites? So crudites are basically mixed raw vegetables which are served as others, and typically with a sauce which they are used as a dipping.
And the ingredients for crudites are?
So carrots and cucumbers, bell peppers, celery, cherry tomatoes. So these are the vegetables that we are going to use. So I start with the cucumber, which we are going to cut them into sticks basically. Not juliennes. Juliennes become very thin, they should be slightly thicker. So once it is cut into sticks, so I am using a glass of ice in which I am going to place these sticks. So the next vegetable I am using is the carrots, which I am going to cut into sticks. So once these sticks are done, again I am going to place them in a glass filled with ice. So there we go. And then move on to the bell peppers. Starting with the yellow. So you can use different vegetables you have to serve them raw basically. So other vegetables also can be done. So I'm using these five basic vegetables here. Rather six vegetables over here. So the yellow ones are done. So the red bell peppers are ready now. So there we go into the glass of ice, and then we go move ahead to the celery. So celery we don't use the leaves generally, so only the stem. So nice clean and wash the stem, and then you can cut them into even size sticks, and then we place them into the glass of ice. And finally the cherry tomatoes, I just used a little bigger toothpick, place three and into the glass it goes. So we are preparing three dips, the first one being a sour cream. The ingredients are hung curd, some cooking cream, lemon juice, salt and pepper. So in a bowl, taken cream, so around 4 tablespoons of cream, to which I am going to add the hung curd. So hung curd gives a little sourness to our cream. So a spoonful of hung curd, blend them properly, and then to this we are going to add a little bit of lemon juice, so it will give the nice sour taste to our preparation. So there we go, lemon juice plus the salt and pepper. Yep, and then nicely mix the entire preparation, and you generally leave it aside for 10-15 minutes. It gives a wonderful texture as well. So there we are set, and into the crucible it goes, ready for our presentation. So this was the first dip, that is sour cream. Now we'll see the next one is smoked chili mayo. So ingredients are mayonnaise, some chilies which are roasted, Tabasco, salt and pepper. So we start by taking up the mayonnaise. The dried red chilies which are roasted, I soaked them in water and made a paste of it, and the same paste I'm going to use along with the mayonnaise. So I'm going to add in the paste, the chili paste. Of course the chilies were de-seeded to reduce the spicy effect. And then a hint of Tabasco. And finally the salt and pepper. So there we go, salt, pepper added, and then nicely blend the mix. And into the crucible, ready for the presentation. So the second one is done, smoked chili mayo, and then the third one is mint in hunkered. So we require hunkered mint leaves, chopped mint leaves, and finely chopped garlic, salt, and pepper. So we start by taking the hunkered in a bowl. So preferably you prepare your own hunkered. It is nice. You get a nice creamy texture. Add the finely chopped garlic. There we go, finely chopped garlic, and then we add in our fresh chopped mint leaves. Do not chop mint leaves in advance and keep, they tend to turn black. So just chop it just before you use at that time. Okay, and then we go ahead and add our seasoning, that is salt and pepper. So try to make these dips as towards the end as possible, towards the service time as possible, to maintain their texture and the texture and flavor. And there you go, you mix it nicely. And then it is done, and there it goes into our crucible, ready for service. So here we are, our crudites are ready. So all served in a glass with ice and the dips. So thank you all, and see you in the next session now.
All right. So we saw what crudites are and the dips along with the crudites. Now we'll go to the next preparation, that is the classical prawn cocktails. And the ingredients for prawn cocktail is
fresh prawns, which we are going to peel, then mayonnaise, tomato ketchup, a hint of Tabasco sauce, lemon juice, which is optional, lettuce, which we'll shred, salt, pepper, tomato, again slices, boiled egg, which we are going to slice, and parsley. So we'll start by peeling the prawns, cleaning them, and boiling them in water with a little salt, and you can add a hint of vinegar and lemon juice, or lemon juice as well. It cooks very fast, that slight curl will come, and you can remove and cool it properly. Once they are cool, we can go ahead and chop them up or cut them into smaller pieces. So there we are, they're cut into small pieces. Now we'll go ahead and prepare our cocktail sauce. So this is a combination of mayonnaise. So I've taken around 3 tablespoons of mayonnaise, and to this we are going to add a couple of dashes of Tabasco, just a couple of shakes maybe, or we can say a few drops. Add Tabasco, followed by you add the tomato ketchup, around 2 spoons of tomato ketchup, pepper. So again I use fresh ground pepper, and salt as per the taste, and blend the entire mix properly. So nice and creamy mix would be ready. Once this mix is ready, we are going to drop in all our chopped prawns into the mix. Gel it up nicely, mix it, and your mixture is done. Now we move ahead into our assembly part. So here I'm using a champagne saucer, which is the classical way of presenting our prawns cocktail. For the base, we use shredded lettuce. So nice fresh lettuce, shred them up nicely, place it in the glass. This will become the base. So once you are set with the lettuce, we go ahead with our prawns mixture. So we put in the prawns mix that we have made with the cocktail sauce. Now just when you're putting it, keep in mind, do not, you know, force the mixture. Don't press it with the spoon and spread it around. Just drop it, and you know, with the spoon you just tap it around. You don't need to spread it. Just let the natural flow of the mix, it will go to the different places where you find, you know, it is empty. It will spread itself to those particular places. So once we are set, our mixture is poured, then we go ahead with the garnishing. Now we start with the tomato slice. So we place tomato slice. Now once our tomato slice is placed, now we go ahead with the egg slice. So you need to boil your egg, slice it up, and then you place a slice of egg on the sliced tomato. And now we place parsley. Now you can also use a slice of black olive also. Gives a nice effect on presentation. Now once this is done, now I'm going to put in the prawn. Now this prawn is a whole prawn, cooked it whole. We have not shelled it, the whole thing is cooked. Now this is going on the glass for added presentation. It looks very nice once it is ready. So here we are, our prawn cocktail is ready. See you for the next preparation. Bye bye.